How's it going, guys? Medium difficulty question for Gastro Step 1. I am Surge2CK. Before we get started, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. Give it a like, really appreciate it. Find me on Instagram threads, Melon underscore medical, MHLMN underscore medical. Links down below. Find me on Telegram. Links to the Telegram group and channel down below. Now start the clip. 54-year-old woman comes to the ED, severe abdo pain for the past 2 hours. She has a history of polycythemia vera. Physical exam shows mild scleroderma. Abdo exam shows a fluid wave with a moderately large liver and spleen. Question wants to know the most likely diagnosis. Let's just hop to the answer choice here. We'll go backwards. Choice E, subcapsular hepatic hematoma. Wrong fucking answer. This is in theory a rare complication of preeclampsia. Preeclampsia, simple definition, is proteinuria hypertension after 20 weeks of pregnancy. If you have a seizure on top of it, we call that eclampsia. Preeclampsia can also lead to other trajectories such as HELLP syndrome, HELLP, hemolysis, elevated liver enzymes, low platelet count. Can also cause subcapsular hepatic hematoma, which is bleeding between the liver capsule and the liver parenchyma, causing a precipitous drop in blood pressure in the pregnant patient. Never seen this assessed on the NBME exams. Wrong fucking answer. Choices C and D, portal and splenic vein thromboses. Wrong fucking answer. Now, they're not outrageous. They're not ludicrous. I mean, sure, we could see both of these when we have an enlarged spleen. Okay, so both of these could cause an enlarged spleen back up to the spleen. Okay, it's not outrageous. And then both of these could be seen in the setting of polycythemia vera, hypercoagulable state. I didn't have to say PCV. I could have said she has history of malignancy. That's hypercoagulable state. They can do that sometimes. So these aren't ludicrous in that regard. However, both of these are classically seen in cirrhosis patients rather than acute hepatomegaly. As I said, it's not ridiculous. You say, why couldn't there be something acute with the liver that ultimately precipitates one of these? Once again, it's not that they're outrageous, it's just they're classically seen in cirrhosis patients, and we have a better answer choice here. That's what you ultimately will do sometimes, where you say, I don't understand why these answer choices are wrong. It's just, well, another answer choice is better, okay? What you ultimately wants you to know is that splenic vein thrombosis is a high yield cause of esophageal varices. Okay? So you can get development of collaterals to the left gastric vein, which will lead to the esophageal veins. Okay? So splenic vein thrombosis, cause of esophageal varices. They asked this a couple times in the 2CK forms. You need to know portal vein thrombosis. So we have the portal vein that's formed by the coalescence of the splenic and the superior mesenteric veins. And the inferior mesenteric vein goes to the superior mesenteric vein. So portal vein thrombosis is an important cause of mesenteric venous thrombosis. They'll tell you a patient has severe abdo pain, laparotomy shows dark slash mottled bowel, and the answer, and they'll give you a history of malignancy or polycythemia vera, and the answer is going to be superior inferior mesenteric venous thrombosis. So these are wrong fucking answers, as I said, because they're usually cirrhosis patients, and we don't have that here. So let's just continue through gallstone ileus. Wrong fucking answer. This is when a patient literally has a gallstone that enters the small bowel and causes an obstruction. Ileus means obstruction of the small bowel. The term itself, ileus, is classically seen postoperatively. Patients who just have decreased peristalsis, classically just parasympathetic impediment. Usually there's manipulation of the bowel via a laparotomy, or there's electrolyte disturbance. But gallstone ileus is when you literally have a stone in the small bowel causing obstruction, and it can be seen when we have a cholecystoduodenal fistula, so a fistula between the gallbladder and the small bowel, and that can be an answer on a USMLE form. What they're going to do, I'm going to simplify this for you, okay? You're going to get a big fucking paragraph. You're going to have no idea what's going on. And they're going to tell you in the last line, there's air visualized in the liver slash in the biliary tree. The answer is just gallstone ileus. It's an extremely buzzy finding that they mention 100% of questions I've seen. So air in the liver slash biliary tree, if they tell you that in the descriptor, especially on a background of fat 40s female fertile, you want to be, which is your cholathiasis demographic, you want to know that that's gallstone ileus right away. Wrong fucking answer. Choice A, Budd Chiari syndrome, correct answer. So this is when we have a thrombosis of the hepatic vein. Okay, and that could acutely cause an enlarged liver and spleen. All right, so hepatic vein thrombosis, Budd Chiari syndrome, holy shit. So the hepatic vein leaves the liver. So that could explain why we have an enlarged liver and spleen, whereas portal vein and splenic vein thromboses, not outrageous, but they're not as good as Budd Chiari syndrome because hepatic vein clearly leaves the liver. So once again, polycythemia vera, hypercoagulable state, malignancy, hypercoagulable state. Budd Chiari syndrome also increased risk in pregnancy. You could be aware of that demographic. And for more of the step one, easier pass level stuff, they could give you a question where they just say hepatic venous pressure is normal, portal venous pressure is increased, and you're like, well, that's not Budd-Chiari syndrome then, because Budd-Chiari syndrome would have increased hepatic venous pressure and increased portal venous pressure. Okay, so you have to just be aware. Hepatic vein leaves the liver, leaves the liver. Portal vein goes to the liver. You know the deal. I'm going to make more content. If you like my stuff, subscribe my channel. Appreciate your time. That's it.